the latest in skill acquisition and performance research from perceptionaction.com. Can one session of differential learning improve visual motor performance? In a new study published in the European Journal of Sports Science, Sarian and colleagues examined this question using a task which involved turning lights presented in the periphery off by hitting them with your hand, kind of like the game I used to play with my kids when we went to Dave and Buster's. The differential learning group trained by doing this in a different way on every trial. For example, moving both hands at once, covering one eye while moving, standing on one foot, waving your hands around before the lights turn on, etc. The comparison group did block practice, in which they repeated several trials using the same movement instruction before switching to a different one. For the differential learning group, there was a greater decrease in reaction time, and they showed more evidence of motor abundance after training. This study adds to the growing body of work showing the benefits of this type of unorthodox practice. For more info about differential learning, check out the resource page I created on perceptionaction.com. In a similar vein, in a study recently published in the Journal of Sport and Human Performance, Sharp and colleagues compared blocked versus random baseball batting practice for both swings from the batter's preferred dominant side and from their non-dominant side. Training involved having high school players hit a ball off a tee 2 sessions per week for 4 weeks. For block training, participants chose the height of the tee, which was then kept constant. They then completed 30 swings, 10 with the tee positioned on the inner half of the plate, 10 in the middle, and 10 on the outside. For the random group, both tee height and tee location were chosen randomly on each trial. The random training led to significantly greater percentage of solid hits for both dominant and non-dominant batting. Once again, variability is a home run in training. Finally today, this week on the Perception and Action podcast, I look at some recent studies investigating the use of situational probabilities and contextual information in sports. For example, knowing your opponent tends to like to drive to the left in basketball. Does knowing your opponent's tendencies make you more susceptible when they try to deceive you? For example, when doing a crossover dribble. Does it matter whether you're given probability information about your opponent or acquire it yourself? How can we account for the use of these types of information sources in an ecological approach to action? Are athletes really using them to predict what their opponent's going to do? Or could they be using them in a different way? Check in to find out. That's the latest from the world of skill acquisition. Find links to the articles I mentioned today on my blog page and learn much more by subscribing to the Perception in Action podcast at perceptionaction.com. Have a great day and keep them coupled.